my name is Leslie, and today we're going to be talking about electricity. So as we know, energy comes in many different forms, and electricity is just one of those. We pretty much use electricity every day of our lives.
From turning on the lights, to keeping our food in the fridge, to powering the computers you're using for school. So what is electricity? Electricity is a form of energy that involves the flow of electrons. Remember that everything around us is made of atoms, and atoms have protons that are positively charged, electrons that are negatively charged, and neutrons that are neutral. And the electrons revolve around the nucleus, which is made of the protons and the neutrons. Usually the number of protons is equal to the number of electrons, so the positive charges and the negative charges balances out. But sometimes when there's an outside force, the balance is destroyed and the atom might lose or gain electrons. So when atoms lose electrons, the electrons can start jumping to another atom. And this free movement of electrons is what causes an electric current. Sometimes electricity can be accidentally generated. For example, static electricity. Static electricity is a stationary charge. This means that it is a charge that is not moving and does not generate any current. It's generated when a surface or material has an imbalance of electric charges, usually from friction, and this charge will stay there until it has a chance to move to a different place. So what does it look like? Have you ever gone down the slide and your hair sticks to it, or your hair sticks to a balloon, or when you rub your feet on the carpet, you can shock one of your friends? All of this is known as static electricity. When two objects are rubbed together, one of the objects gives up electrons, and the other one gains the electrons. This means that one of them is now more positively charged, while the other is more negatively charged. Now let's take a closer look at the objects. We know that like charges repel each other, so the two negative charges want to get as far away from each other as possible. So this is why your hair stands up when it's statically charged. Each of your hairs wants to be as far away from each other as they can. Then, when you touch someone else or touch a piece of metal, you sometimes feel that shock before you even fully touch the other object. This is because you guys are creating a path for the electricity to reach the ground. You are closing the circuit, and this sudden discharge of energy is what creates the spark that we call a shock. Now, lightning is a great example of static electricity in nature. Basically, the water droplets in a cloud are rubbing together, and the friction causes a separation of charges, where the positive charges line up at the top and the negative at the bottom. Now, on the Earth's surface, we have houses and buildings and trees, which have positive charges that can line up with the cloud. And if these charges get big enough, it can cause a sudden discharge of electrical energy so that the negative charge can connect with the positive charge, and the energy can reach the ground. Lightning wants to take the fastest route to the ground, which is why we construct tall lightning poles to protect the rest of our buildings from this static electricity. While static electricity can be dangerous, it can also be useful. Our photocopiers and laser printers use the principles behind static electricity to do their jobs.
All right, so we're going to do three experiments to see this in action. But before starting, make sure you have your parent or guardian's permission. Okay guys, so for our first experiment, I'm gonna show you how to move water without touching it. So what you're gonna need, you're gonna grab a balloon and go to your nearest sink. So you might wanna ask your parent or guardian for a little help with this one, but come on, I'll show you. Okay, so as you can see, I'm with my sink. So the first step you're gonna do is you're gonna charge the balloon. So how we do that is you're just gonna rub it in your hair until you kind of start seeing your hair stick to it. Rub it a little more and remember what side you rub your hair on. Okay, so now with your tap, you're gonna turn it on just so it's a little stream. Something along that big is good. And you can ask your parents for help at this step. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna lift the tap up. And with your charged balloon, you're gonna bring it close to the stream of water and watch what happens. Do you guys see the bend? So here I have a balloon that's not charged, so I didn't rub it on my hair. And let's see what happens when I bring it close to the string. So nothing happens. So isn't that cool? We were able to move the water without ever even touching it. So why do you guys think that's possible?
So let's take a closer look at the three scenarios that we saw, with the water stream by itself, the charged balloon, and the non-charged balloon. So the water stream by itself has neutral water coming out it, meaning that the water has a balance of positive and negative charges in it. The charged balloon has excess negative charges near the surface. So when we put it close to the stream of water, the negative charges attract the positive charges in the water, and it kind of acts like a magnet. But when the balloon isn't charged, the balloon itself also has a balance of positive and negative charges. So when we put it near the water, nothing happens. For our balloon to pull the water towards it, it needs to have the extra negative charges near the surface.
All right, so for our second experiment, I'm going to show you how to make salt and pepper float in the air. So you're going to need to grab a plate, grab some pepper, grab some salt, and you need your trusty balloon here. So to start, I'm going to get you to mix some salt and pepper on this plate. So as you can see on this plate, we have a mixture of salt and pepper. Next, you're going to take your balloon and charge it. So really rub it on your hair until you kind of see your hair stick to it. That means the balloon is getting charged. And then, let's get this hair in control. When you place the balloon close to the plate without actually touching it, you can see the salt and pepper starting to float. So taking a closer look, I just added a box so that we can see it better. But when we bring our balloon close without touching the plate, you can hear it start to float up. See, we're picking up the salt and pepper without even touching it. And if you look on your balloon, you can see the salt and pepper sticking to it. So now, why do you think that happens?
Let's draw this out. So you have your plate, and you fill it with your salt and your pepper. And just like the water, the salt and pepper have balanced charges of protons and electrons. So altogether, they're neutral. Then when we add our charged balloon that has excess electrons on the side of it, we start to pull up the salt and pepper by attracting their protons. Now a question we can ask is, why is there more pepper than salt on the balloon? And the answer is simple. It's because the pepper is lighter. Now, if we imagine this is our piece of salt and this is our piece of pepper, both have protons and electrons. However, the salt has more simply because it's bigger. So you can see that picking up pepper is easier than picking up salt, just like how picking up a small object with a magnet is easier than a larger object.
Okay, so for our final experiment, we're going to have a pop can race. So you can do this with someone else in your house, or you can time yourself and try and beat your score. But the catch is, you can't actually touch the pop can. So what you're going to need is an empty pop can. Make sure that it's dry. I have my trusty finish line that I'm going to put at the end of my race. And then, of course, you're going to need your balloon. So, you're going to place your pop can on its side, and then we're going to charge our balloon again. So, rub it in your hair real good until it starts sticking to your hair. So, maybe a little more. Alright, so I think that's charged enough. And then, watch what happens when I put the balloon close to the pop can. It starts coming towards it. And then, yay! Notice how I'm pulling the pop can instead of pushing it. So let's see it again. Why do you think that I can move the pop can with the balloon?
So again, let's draw out our neutral pop can, meaning that it has the same amount of protons and electrons. Then we can draw out our charged balloon that has extra electrons near the surface. Because of the attraction of the protons to the electrons, as we move our balloon towards the finish line, the pop can will be attracted and move with it.
So that's it for the experiments today. Let's recap. What did we learn? First, we learned about electricity as a form of energy, and we learned about static electricity. Atoms make up all the matter around us, and they have neutrons, protons, and electrons. When electrons move around, they can jump from one atom to another atom, and this creates what we call an electric current. And static electricity is a stationary electric charge that we can create with friction. Remember that one object gains the electrons and becomes more negatively charged, while the other loses its electrons and becomes more positively charged. And then we saw all of these principles in action. First, we made water move without even touching it. Second, we made salt and pepper float. And third, we were able to move a pop can. So make sure to try all these experiments at home. And you can share your pictures and videos on the Future Energy Systems Facebook page, and it'll be linked below. I'm excited to see what you do.
Thank you so much for watching Future Energy Systems video. Make sure to subscribe so you don't miss any of our exciting content. Check out the links below to our website and learning page where you can find activities, learning extension, and more. You can also sign up on the website for notifications for future videos and interactive opportunities. There's so much to learn as we explore our energy future.